As coreboot developers, we very frequently work long on long projects, on complex projects, and it is very important to have good documentation related to designs, concepts, assumptions, stipulations, and like any problems, debugging sessions, and this kind of stuff, because the problems are typically very complex, and it's good to have your own way of documenting this complex process. So if you will switch context, you will get back after a couple of days, you can quickly continue where you stopped. So developer documentation is very important. You should document any bugs you find, because like from one perspective it may bite you later. From other perspective, it would be great if you can contribute fixes to coreboot project. Definitely, rule is quality over quantity. Please try to be concise, and do not like write big elaborates, because this doesn't help anyone. Nobody has time to read documentation. Focus on the target. So if you're writing documentation, please think for who you're writing. So for example, if you will write something for doc.coreboot.org, it typically can be not coreboot hacker, coreboot expert. It may be some user. So please try to be less like more user-friendly. Do not use too much of complex terminology. Also, if this is for vendors, this also have to have different perspective. And for developers, you can use like all the style that is already in the source code in the comments. So in terms of doc.coreboot.org, this is something that replaced the previous wiki. And so wiki is considered right now deprecated, but still contains a lot of valuable information which was created over last I don't know 10 plus years. But now coreboot migrates to Sphinx and start to use doc.coreboot.org for all the documentation. It's much more friendly. We suggest to read that and to support if you find any bugs there.